Hi, how's it going? I thought it would be interesting to make a new series about more serious game dev stuff. As you know, I'm a game developer by trade, and I think I can share with you some of the stuff I do in this new series, where I show you some actual game systems I developed for actual real-life game production. Sort of a code review, if you will. This video is sponsored by Surfshark VPN. The first topic I'd like to go over with you is context-aware AI-powered text translation. I put an emphasis on context-aware because I think this is the most interesting part of all this, but we'll get back to it later. First, I need to tell you what I needed to make and why. The game we're currently working on is approaching the point where we're going to need to talk to publishers, send a prototype build, and try to convince them that this game is worth making. Our writer has been writing stories and dialogues to integrate into the game. They've been writing in French because, you know, French team. But the prototype we will show to international publishers needs to be in English, so we need to translate everything. Now in the future, I hope we'll be able to hire human translators to translate the game into as many languages as we can afford. But right now, purely for cost reasons, because the game has basically a budget of $0, we need to do this English demo version ourselves. I could probably translate the text into English myself, but I feel like ChatGPT would probably do a better job than I would. Or at least it would output a good first version that I can improve upon. I'm not sure I would trust it blindly to translate into, say, Japanese, a language I have absolutely no knowledge of, but at least with English, I can assess the quality of the output translation and rectify it if needs be. So we're going to automate the translation of text directly in Unity using ChatGPT, or rather GPT 3.5. We're using the Unity localization package, which is, in my opinion, very well made, very versatile, and has the capacity to adapt to the multiple quirks and irks of the multitude of languages you can throw at it. Before that, I want to tell you about the sponsor of today's video, Surfshark VPN, because somehow in 2023, you're still not using a VPN. Basically, a VPN reroutes your internet traffic into an encrypted pipe, and when it emerges at the other end, it seems like you're browsing from another location in the world. This can be useful for protecting your data from people who might want to snoop on it. But it can also be useful to pretend you live in, say, Canada, and get access to content that would otherwise not be available in your country, like some Netflix libraries or YouTube videos. Surfshark has servers in 100 countries, so just click on the one you want and a few seconds later, voila, all your traffic is rerouted. What's great about Surfshark is they allow you to set up an unlimited number of devices. So I could protect my desktop computer, my laptop, my cat, my phone, even my TV. Also, they offer a 30-day money-back guarantee, so really there's no risk in giving it a try. Check out the link in the description and use code USELESSGDEV for 93 extra months free. Okay, let's go back to translating the game and thank you Surfshark for sponsoring this video. So we've written French text that we want to translate to English. Note that I set up a temporary intermediate locale called English GPT. The reason for that is that I don't want the AI to just output into the English locale. I want to be able to manually move the string to English myself, checking for mistakes in each one along the way. I certainly don't want the game to end up with a dialogue that says server error, invalid request or whatever. Diving into the code for a moment, it starts by fetching the entries that need to be translated. This is done by first getting every entry in the table we want to translate from. We'll apply two filters, first a regex filter of the name of the key, for instance, say I want every key that starts with quest. The second filter is a simple checkbox to only include entries that don't have any translation in the target language yet. This way, I don't overwrite stuff that has already been translated, especially since calling the API costs money. Then once we have a list of entries, we're going to translate each of them sequentially, and then wait for some time to avoid getting caught by the rate limiting system. Translating an entry in itself is just calling the ChatGPT function, and then adding the results in the target table using the right key. The actual API call is in this ChatGPT translate function. What it does is it builds the prompt and then calls the API, and that's about it. I use the C# wrapper for the Open API by OKGoDoIt. It is very well made and works very well with Unity. Let's look at the generated prompt. It starts very simply with translate this text, but sometimes the result was very ChatGPT-esque and would be like, here's the translated text. So I added that, no, I just want the result, thank you. Our text has rich text formatting to highlight names, places, important items, but no matter what I tried, it didn't know what to do with the XML tags and tried translating them. It was a real mess, so I just ended up stripping every XML tag from the text before translation, and I'll add them manually later. And then in between, there's context. What do I mean by context aware? Well, Unity localization has a cool feature to add metadata to a text entry. Mainly you can add comments that will get exported along in the CSV file to provide to your translator to indicate, I don't know, max size, intent, lore, whatever. But you can also add your own metadata types, so we'll add two, feeling and character. A feeling is just a text that indicates for this specific entry what the general tone and vibe is about. Look at this line of dialogue where a character says they have lost everything. The original translation is this, but if I have the feeling context that the speaker is crying, then the translation will actually preserve the tone and the stuttering. Pretty cool, right? We can go further than that. Rather than adding custom context on each and every line of dialogue, let's make a character metadata that simply contains the name of the speaker. Then we'll make a scriptable object with the character sheets, where I can add a short description of the character, how they speak, if they're using slang, and then every line of dialogue that is tagged with this character will get that common description added to the prompt. Keep in mind, the context will not have a huge impact on translation. After all, the original text already provides all the words to translate, and especially on small line of dialogues, there isn't much room for the AI to get creative. It would probably have more impact if I said like, hey, write a line of dialogue from scratch, here's some context on the character and on the vibe. So here's what the final tool looks like. You start by filling the fields with what content you want to translate, what locale to translate from, what locale to translate to, and the name of the language, in my case, English. Add the character sheet if needed. Then there's two settings for API calls, mainly the request per minute maximum to make sure we don't go over the rate limit. The mock checkbox when checked will do a dry run without actually calling ChatGPT in order to save on API calls. Then you click fetch entries and will list all entries that are about to be translated based on the filters just above. You can also remove some when you review the list. Then when you're satisfied with what you're about to translate, click translate. It does its thing and then you can see the translated text in the localization table. If you're not satisfied with one of the results, you can go back and click quick translate to rerun the translation on this specific key. Sometimes it gives different results. And that's it. This is going to be a super useful tool to get some quick translation going, good enough for a first draft anyway. In the end, for this prototype, we translated about 7,000 words over 300 lines of dialogue, and it cost us about 4 cents. This little tool is separate enough from the game, so I'm going to share it on Patreon. So if you want to use it for your own projects, head over there to grab the source code. I hope you enjoyed this new format. We'll definitely go back to the usual silly, useless game dev content in the next videos, but this code review series is just getting started. We're developing plenty of systems for the game that would be very interesting to talk about. There's scene management, memory optimization, procedural generation, and many more. And also at some point we'll start talking about the actual game, so that's also something I look forward to sharing with you. Make sure to check out Surfshark using the link in the description and use promo code USELESSGDEV to get 3 extra months free. I hope I'll see you in the next video. Until then, thank you very much for watching and have a good one.